Hello everyone, welcome to this multi-part tutorial of the Winload software. Winload is the predecessor of Babyware. It's an older software, so you shouldn't really use it except for situations where you have no choice. So for example, if you're trying to connect to a DGP panel, an old panel like a 1738 or 1728 or something like that, you cannot use Babyware to connect to those because they are not supported anymore. There are benefits, however, to using Winload if your panel is still supported. Like for example, the SP6000, it's a newer panel, but it's still supported by both Winload and Babyware. So if you prefer, you can still use Winload for it. And the reason why you would need this is if you're doing the switch from programming with a keypad, now you're trying to use the computer. So Winload has the sections labeled in the software, as we will see. I'm here on the Paradox website, so software and apps. Sorry. So if I go to software and apps, it's not listed here. So you'd actually have to go and search for it in the search box, and you will see here Winload. So this is how you can download it. Once you download it, the installation is straightforward. You're going to select the default options. There's nothing tricky there. So I already have my software downloaded and installed. So the default username is master. Default password is 1234. And once you open it, you get a clean interface like this. So here, obviously, it's the you choose the language of your preference. Accounts is you can create a new account, define your panel, and so forth. You can open an account if you have a few accounts listed here. You can select them from the open menu or from this icon here. So this is open account, new account. You can delete an account from here. You can create groups. So if you have if you want to group your accounts into residential and commercial, for example, or in some other way, let's say if a client has multiple sites and you want to group them in a separate group so you can find them easier, you can do that from here. You can create the group, and then when you create the account, you can put them into those groups. Under setup, this is the most important one. So you have your connections here. So I only use those two sections, modem connection or direct connection. So if you're dialing into your customer's alarm panel using the phone line, so here you'd need a modem, of course. So you connect your modem and you find it from the device manager. You find which COM port it's connected on, and then you select which type of modem you have, and then you can usually you don't have to set up these sections unless it's required by your modem. You can here select your region, put the area code, and so forth. Then this is for the modem part. For the direct connection, which it's more of what you would be using it for. So here you would select where your you obviously need the connector, just like Babyware. So you would need the USB 307. So let me show you what it is. So USB. So if you have, this is the older one, the USB 306. It's actually not this one. So USB USB, let's do this is the newer one. So this is what it looks like. So if you have, this is what you would need to connect to the panel. So this side plugs in the serial port of the panel, and you need a USB cable, which is not provided in the box. You need a USB cable to connect this to your computer. And then once you connect it, you download, you need the driver. So you download the driver from here. Download USB drivers and install it, and then it should show in your device manager. So you open your device manager under COM ports here, so it should be listed as USB, but of course I already see it here, so there's not really a point of opening the device manager. You can choose it from here. So it's going, in my case it's COM 8. So you select it and say close, and that's it. Your Winload is ready to use. So unlike Babyware, in Babyware we select those serial connections from the account. Here it's different. Here it's selected for the whole software. So if you get a new serial port and you need to change it, so you change it here for all the accounts. Passwords, you can change your master code from here. You can change the 1234 that is that I use to log in. You can change it from here. You can also create new users and give them permissions. So for example, if you have a junior employee that you want to only be able to download logs, for example, so you can set this from here. I won't go through this. You can experiment this with this on your own, but that's I'm just mentioning it so you know. You can also open the infield programmer from here. However, I do recommend that you not use this. You download the infield if you need. This is the tool to upgrade your panel. You can use this tool to upgrade the panel, whether it's an alarm panel or an ACM or whatever. You can upgrade it using this tool. So again, I do recommend that you download the latest version from the Paradox website, because the one that is included here may not be up to date and may not support all of the all of the panels that you're connected to. Database, you can back up the database from here. However, I will show you how to export the accounts separately or together. It's a better way, more reliable way. It's important to back up your accounts once in a while, because like I said, at some point that software is going to lock up, it's going to freeze, and you're not going to be able to get out of it except by ending the task. And when you do that, your database is going to get corrupted and you will have to restore it. So you will have to either back up the database from here, or better yet, you can you can export the accounts like I'm going to show you later on in the next episode. So that's all you have to do for this part of the tutorial. See you in the next one.